if you are in Orlando and you're trying to get into real estate, you might be feeling the housing pinch, right? They're squeezing us landlords out with the prices these days. It's okay, though. I have a low-cost solution. Let's go. This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs. I'm going through the MLS, and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world. Welcome to the show, folks. My name is James Wise. This is Holton Wise TV. And what I do here is help investors like you invest in real estate, the cheapest real estate in the world sometimes. Well, maybe not the world, but the cheapest real estate markets in the U.S., right? That's what we aim to do, right? We go where the cash flow is, right? Where you live, not really what we focus on. We focus on where the cash flow is, right? So today, my client, his name is Brian. He's from Orlando, Florida. And the market in Orlando, Orlando's a great place. No complaints about Orlando, folks, other than it's very hard to be a buy and hold investor in Orlando right now. I mean, definitely hard if you're not super rich, right? Brian's a regular guy like me, regular guy like you, regular gal like you, right? So the property that I have today, Brian, I think you're really going to dig it, right? This one in Elyria, Ohio. Me and you have been focused on that area quite a bit because I really like that area right now. It's in the Cleveland market, and I like it a little more than Cleveland number one. And this is a side-by-side duplex that I previously looked at for somebody. They ended up going another direction, which is totally cool. That's what this is about, right? It's about finding a property that fits your needs. So it's still available. So good news for you, brother. I think it'll be perfect based on my work with you. I think you're going to dig it. Let's take a look at that footage now.
Two, please.
I think it's too big.
No, I think it'll shrink in a lot.
Welcome back. Let's jump into the deal. I love this deal quite a bit, okay? 210 14th Street, Elyria, 44035. Been on the market 7 days, priced at 89K. Now, I love Elyria, dude. Oh, my God, do I love Elyria, right? Here's the cool thing about Elyria. This is why I really love it. On a national stage, people are like, looking at the Cleveland market, right? Investors all over the place. Like, there's always articles or this or that about Cleveland's a great cash flow market. If you want to get cash flow properties, Cleveland, Cleveland, Cleveland. It pops up everywhere, right? You know, you do something like, what are the best cash flow markets in the United States? Cleveland's always in the top 10, right? Sometimes it's even listed as number one on a lot of those publications, right? What's cool about all that is that it's Cleveland, Cleveland, Cleveland. It beats into everybody out there's head that all the Cleveland area is the city of Cleveland. Not the case, right? The city of Cleveland's got like 350,000 people in there, right? The greater area, several million, okay? So there's a lot of suburbs in and around that area that are not getting a lot of attention. Elyria is one of them. I think it's a nice little sleepy suburb. It's like 40 minutes west of the city of Cleveland. And for those of you that are looking for some type of comparison here, right, where LeBron is from, Akron, right? Everybody says, LeBron's from Cleveland, LeBron's from Cleveland, LeBron's from Cleveland. LeBron's not from Cleveland, LeBron's from Akron. That's south of Cleveland, about the same distance, right? So it's in the general area, right? We service Elyria. We have tons of properties in Elyria, right? But it's off the radar, which is great because it allows us, in my opinion, to pick up deals we couldn't have otherwise got if they were in Cleveland. This property would not have remained on the market for 7 days if it was in Cleveland, folks. $89,000. This thing's awesome. It's a side-by-side duplex. Side-by-side duplexes are, in fact, the best friggin' duplexes. Now, it's fully occupied with long-term tenants, so do not expect this thing to be like spick and span, beautiful, looking fresh, looking clean. The real estate agent for the seller only provided one photo because, guys, it's really friggin' tough to go through tenants' houses and take pictures. They don't, like, want to deal with all you fucking assholes, like, interrupting their life. But it don't really matter. Some people think that's a red flag. It's not. There ain't nothing special you're going to see in there, folks. I'm going to tell you this right now. I already know what it looks like. It looks like it needs a turnover when these tenants move out. They're long-term tenants, folks. You do not get to buy $90,000 duplexes in the Cleveland market with long-term tenants, and then when they move out, you just sweep it up and it's ready to rent for the next tenant. That don't fucking happen. If that's your expectation, it's wrong. You're going to need to refresh the unit. Paint! If they got carpet, we're replacing it. I like to replace it with vinyl or hardwood so you mitigate that cost in the future. You don't have to deal with that again, right? We may need to do Home Depot, Lowe's quality kitchen cabinets, bath fixtures, right? So we might be looking at like $5,000, $10,000, $15,000 per unit when these folks eventually move out, right? These folks have been there for quite a long time, and it already cash flows where they're at, $750 and $600. But market rent, since it's side-by-side, which is the premium layout, folks, that's $800 a unit, $1,600 a month, or $19,200 a year, right? They have it listed at $89. We need to pay $89, okay? I assume there's eventually going to be multiple offers on this. Yes, it's still on the market today because it's got an Elyria address as opposed to a Cleveland address, and it's getting less national traction. But look, a lot of people understand this is going to make money because this thing's a fucking cash cow. So be prepared to pay $89 or more, right? $1,600, long-term market rents. After you run your fixed and variable expense estimates with HoltonWise handling everything on the ground for you, you're looking at an NOI of about $709 for the month on average, $85 for the year on average. Some years will be better, some will be worse, right? As you see, we got capital expenditures. I'm saving up $960 every year for you, right? That's for things like roofs, furnaces, hot water tanks, none of which are anticipated to be new. This is not a scenario where we get under contract for like $90,000 and then we get the inspection report back and you're like, oh my God! The roof is like 20 years old. How much is a roof? And I go, oh, well, this roof would probably be like $7,000 to replace. You go, oh, my God, ask the seller for $7,000 off. No, motherfucker, it's not. No, look, this house is worth every bit of $89 or more in its current condition with long-term tenants paying below market rent, with units that are dated, and there is no expectation of there being a new roof, a new furnace, or a new hot water tank. I factored that type of stuff into your analysis here, folks. Capital expenditures, right? $960 a year. You don't do a roof every year, obviously. You do a roof once every 30 years. Costs about $7,000. Hot water tanks. You're usually going to be replacing those bad boys every 15 years. Costs about a G right now. Furnaces cost about 3 Gs. You're usually doing those about every 3 years. None of these mechanicals are brand new, folks. They're all currently working. Why would the seller replace them? If you got a furnace, it's probably going to work for another 5 years. Why the fuck would you replace it? You wouldn't, right? So the property's going to be worth that. Those are the proper expectations. The thing's still going to kick off a ton of money, right? Who's to say we actually have to kick these tenants out to get them up to market? If we slowly get them up to market, right, slowly bring them up, we wouldn't have to have a turnover, and then we'd be looking at a friggin' 23.1% cash-on-cash return, right? Only $22,250 out of your pocket. This is a solid investment. As far as Elyria goes as compared to Cleveland, I've already mentioned that nationally people aren't paying attention to it enough. In my opinion, Elyria, it's like a high C. Maybe I might even consider it like a B neighborhood, dude. I believe personally that the tenant base in Elyria is a little more easygoing to work with. I feel like we're doing better with our Elyria tenant base than a lot of the West Side neighborhoods in Cleveland we deal with, right? Crime appears to be lower, and like I just feel like overall we're doing very well. Like if you give me the Cleveland, West Side of Cleveland, Elyria, I enjoy investing in both of them, but right now I believe Elyria is probably the better play that a lot of people don't know about. Additionally, the government, much easier to deal with, right? Like, this is a Cleveland market, folks. There's a lot of different cities out here, right? Cleveland, East Cleveland, Cleveland Heights, right? A lot of people think those three are the same. They're not. That's three completely different cities. Then we got Elyria, we got Luray, we got Lakewood, Rocky River, Garfield Heights, Bedford Heights, Newburgh Heights, Parma Heights, Parma, Brook Park, right? All these areas in the greater Cleveland area, every single one of them has a different government, different rules, different procedures, right? That's why you hire HoltonWise, because we can navigate all that. But what I'm telling you right now is I am really big on Elyria. And the other thing, too, didn't stress this enough, I'm really big on the fact that this is a side-by-side duplex. A, you get more rent, but B, what you do is and it's more important than the additional rent. Like, if this is an up-down, I would say the market rent's about 750, right? We squeeze an extra 50 bones because it's the up-down layout, or the side-by-side layout versus the up-down layout. We squeeze out an extra 50 bones per unit there, right? But that $100 a month, $1,200 a year, that's not what I love about it. What I love about it is it reduces turnover. You get long-term tenants, right? Because it's not as much sound annoyance, right? Nobody's above you. Nobody's below you, right? That kind of stuff causes tenants to fight. When tenants fight, they become unhappy. When they're unhappy, guess what? One of them usually moves out, right? So that becomes a problem. And the majority of duplexes in the entire Cleveland market, all the cities I just mentioned, most of them, I would say like 95% are built with the up-down layout. So whenever you get the opportunity to pick up a side-by-side property, absolutely do it. So in my opinion, there's no such thing as a can't-lose deal, but this is very much as close to that as I think you can possibly get in the Cleveland market. For your money right now, this duplex is a friggin' banger. Let me know what you want to do.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to HoltonWise TV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.